All right, so last we left off, we said that we're going to build somewhat of a level and then talk to you about the theme of the
Well,
episode.
we're gonna finish building out the level, right? So you didn't have to sit and watch us build it and not talk. And then come back to it and kind of talk about what needs to be iterated with it. So I've actually uploaded it already, but
A week passed.
yeah.
No, spoiler alert. A week passed, and this kid just I don't even know what he did. Like, literally, this episode is going to be the finishing off with me playing whatever he did and talking about it as I probably die a lot. So we'll find out.
I also bought new lights. Look how bright we are.
Ah, I got a haircut.
All right, let's jump in. So
Mariovania.
it's going to be challenging. Probably this is probably going to be one of the things that we do have to adjust is we need to make it easier. And I actually recorded Cujo playing what? Just got killed.
What do you mean?
Oh, that's interesting. I think a chain chomp that I put somewhere in the level just got killed.
Nice.
That's the first that's actually happened, but it happened, I guess. So I actually recorded Cujo playing this level, and
Sorry.
we'll actually release that as like a special bonus episode at some point.
I imagine he starts getting very frustrated.
Oh, he was very much
Oh,
the typical YouTuber playing challenging Mario levels,
That's
where he
good.
just made lots of like noises.
That's good. So far, you start off by having that coin under the block. Seemed kind of rudimentary, but it was very basic. Like, hey, look, here's a coin. You should totally jump on this block here.
Yeah, and for the most part, this is all stuff that you've sort of already seen. Like, this actually didn't change tremendously. This is one thing that did change.
Okay, so here we go. Look at that. Oh, look, there's gonna be a mushroom. Mushrooms are important. Look at that arrow right there. All right, cool. So I should know where to go. All right, and can't move back. So there's only one way to go. I guess I'm gonna go this way because those are my options. Oh, you had to make a creepy. Cool. No secrets here.
You like my little face?
Oh yeah.
Cujo didn't even notice that at first. I was like, "Hey, Cujo, do you like my little
Yeah,
face?" And
but
he was like,
he's
"What?
looking at
There was
you.
a face?"
Great.
Thanks, Cujo.
So now that this, I can. Oh, I was supposed to bounce there, wasn't I?
I mean, it's fine.
Ah,
It's
okay.
fine.
It's all good.
It's good. It's Mario coping with.
Why?
So you notice you see the little thwomps up there, so you're like, well, shit.
And I saw the
how
thwomps before, which is so it's like a little repeat, which makes me think all that is connected.
And you just got a mushroom. This is kind of one of the recurring themes of this level is
Ah, you
generally don't
son
want
of
to
a
get the
bitch.
You know, when I first made this level, every time I tested it out, I always got killed by those thwomps, and I knew they were there too. I was just like, I can't
Gotta go,
slow
gotta go,
down
gotta go.
fast enough.
Oh.
Triple arrow, what does it mean?
Go, 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 go. Go, 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 go. Go! So, that was my fault because I could see the yellow blocks down there, and that was a clear indicator that maybe I should rely on those.
The trouble with designing that part two was I don't think, or rather, I do think that if I had the thwomp any lower, even at full speed, I think he would have hit the player. And so I guess I could experiment with that a little bit more, but
You should make that like the icon for the stage.
that
I
face?
guess yeah I guess it's too late now, but yeah, you can if you're on that part of the screen when you save it, it will save that as the icon for the
Oh,
stage.
really?
Yeah.
Oh man, I wish I knew that. Where I think the part that it did save the icon wasn't a bad place, but it was not as thematic.
Ah!
Oh.
I got too greedy. All right. I'm still messing around. Right?
Getting serious.
Getting serious. What's this? Give me that
You
second mushroom.
already did this.
Give me that
Oh,
second
I don't know if
mushroom.
I finished that train of thought, but one of the recurring themes is
Die. Right here. Die right here.
That
That you
you
can't do
probably
anything about
don't
this
want to
one.
hit all the question mark blocks. Not unless you know that you've lost something.
So, like, now I'm boned. Why would
but
you do that?
Are you boned?
I mean, so, like, my guess is I would have either needed a cape or a fire flower there because it was inevitable I was going to get hit. So I would need to be able to survive an additional hit.
So there's actually a hint. Where are you going?
Back?
Why don't you get a mushroom?
Oh, I can go back into that room,
right? It's a pipe generator. That's exactly why I led you back here.
Well, that's... Okay, fine. That's fair. I forget that things regenerate sometimes.
That's the whole reason I had the player go down into this room and have a pipe generated. Was specifically so they're not just, like, infinitely spawning it into this single room, and by the time you get up there, you're like, there's 100 mushrooms! Oh my god! And so I was like, okay, well, I'll use this to my advantage, and I'll kind of make it a thematic thing. So every time you get one of the Metroidvania, like, equipment pieces, it's going to be in a room like that. So it means if you ever lose it, you can go back and get it again. That's probably the thing I'm the happiest about this level, is that even though it's challenging, it doesn't totally penalize you for failure. It doesn't... You don't lose lives, right?
Yeah. I mean, yeah, it's... Unlike a Metroidvania actually does, but...
Right, but it's a big thing with Mario Maker levels.
I did it again.
It's a big thing with Mario Maker levels, right, where a lot of people will make the challenging levels just gratuitously difficult. We even saw this before we even started recording today. You were dicking around playing some Stranger's levels, and right off the bat, there were just, like, incredibly difficult challenges at the very, like...
Literally, there was a saw right in my face, and which was sad because the rest of the level was cool.
And I hate that. When you're playing 100 Mario Challenge in this game, that's like the worst thing you could do to your players.
Be unnecessarily difficult. Yeah, that's right. Throw it that way. How do you like it?
I swear if you get hit by
How do you like it?
You know, the...
That's not even fair!
Oh, buddy.
So anyway, this world champion, whatever they called it, you can unlock the levels from it, and they're pretty cool for the most part. Make it. Nah. I'm ashamed.
I can play it if you want.
No. I have more pride than Cujo.
Cujo said the same thing.
Cujo did let you finish it, and nah, I'm not going to.
It's true, he did.
No!
Have you forgotten that spin jump works on thwomps?
Yeah, but you have to jump high enough.
You went down to that thwomp. Cujo did the same thing.
But I'm holding Y.
You have to go from above for some reason.
But I'm holding Y.
I know.
But I'm holding... I should be able to grab it. No, I didn't want to do that.
It works that way with the red and green shells, right?
Yeah.
It doesn't,
yes, it does.
For some reason with those shells, it doesn't. I don't know why.
But I'm holding Y.
I really wish there was a better way to teach players, because this is a totally new mechanic, right? Where you can actually wear it.
Yeah, that is completely new.
And how are players going to find that out? Other than, like, through accidents or experimentation, right? Like, there's no way I could be like, hold and hit down. There's just no easy way to do that. I could, like, put a coin message out, and that would look like crap.
Yeah. Yes, it would. Ugh. What just died?
One of the little spiky beetles. Things are dying in this playthrough, and I don't know why. This didn't happen when I was building the stage.
Hey. You ugly.
Bam.
No.
I think I might want to, remove some of those little blocks to make it easier to hit that landing.
Uh-oh. I deserve that. You're gonna have to do so much editing.
So I think one of the reasons you're having a hard time getting through this level is because you're very timid about a lot of it. But the thing is that that's how most players are gonna be.
Yes, number one. Why? See that right there? I hate that.
That's fair. No, I actually totally agree with that. I didn't actually mean to make that challenging.
Pink. Dry bones. Yeah, I mean, well, you gotta be careful if you're unfamiliar with this stage.
There you go. That's exactly how I do it. You know, you could just hit down on the D-pad, right?
I did not know that, but that's less fun.
It is less fun, I agree.
So, remember when you were talking about some stages are just too long because there's no checkpoint?
That is the biggest failure of this design, I think.
You got level happy.
I got level happy, but...
Oh, that's the other thing. You can't go back safely.
You can. You just can't use a full jump.
I didn't.
If you use the spin jump, you can make it through the whole way.
Oh.
But I agree. This level does suffer from not having checkpoints. Which is why I wanted to make it so that you don't die with a huge amount of frequency. You just have to go back and collect the right components.
Yeah, but the distance is just so great on some of them.
Yeah.
Like having to go back for that shell three times, that was just frustrating.
I've considered adding a door. After you get, like, each of the pieces of equipment, just have a door that brings you back to the beginning of the stage.
See, that would be pretty awesome.
The only downside of that is that it prevents the player from seeing what their new piece of equipment is benefiting, or how their new piece of equipment is benefiting them.
Easy way of solution for that, I think, is to have it to where all of the, oh no. All right, well, that's what it is. Have all of the ways to see what that piece of equipment does right there at the beginning. Yeah. Like, as in, like, this path goes here, this path does this, or whatever the case is. Players will look at it and be like, well, obviously, that's not a smart idea for me to, like, I should not go that way because I don't have any way to protect my head. And then later, they go by, and then they get the helmet, and then, you know, they take the door, get back to the end, or the beginning, and they're like, bam, look at that, now I can use my helmet.
Yeah, that's fair.
Go Zelda style on him. Ah.
Dry bones.
I fucking hate him. You know what it probably was? Is just the type of placement of a lot of the enemies. You know what? I should go up there. And the only reason I know I should go up there, though, is because I fucked up that one time. Then again, this is Metroidvania, so it's about exploration. Oh wait, I'm not big, so, you know, that's cool.
I'm gonna show you a secret. Spin jump up that thwomp. Don't get hit by that shell, or that bone, though. And do a little bit of a bigger bounce. It didn't work out quite as well as it was supposed to. But yeah, that's a thing.
So we know why this stage is so hard. It's because the creator's a sadistic asshole.
I'm not sadistic!
Let me show you a little secret. Oh, look, you got hit because you couldn't avoid getting hit. Because fuck you.
Because you didn't spin jump. Did you catch the other face in that room, by the way?
Yeah, I thought that it was actually the same face, is it not?
The face on the left is. But look on the right.
Why?
The first face is like, you don't know what you're in for. The second face is how you're feeling right now.
Yep. Like, life is unfair. Why am I doing this? Why have I chosen to play Mario?
Tony's joined the party, everybody.
Hey.
So happy right
or
now.
Or Geekarius. Geekarius.
Yeah, how come he gets his gamer tag and I don't even get mine? You even said I should use my gamer tag and then you won't use it.
Intangible. Be quiet.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Sorry, I'm here a little early, I guess.
Oh, you're big. Hey, you did it.
I like your shell helmet.
And where are we at now? All right. I swear to God, if something happens in this area that forces me to go all the way back, you suck.
All right. I'm glad we've established that.
Oh, hey, look, another one of those things went down, huh? Is that you're talking about, Chris?
The Thwomps, yeah.
Yeah, the Thwomps knocking out your dudes.
See, this part isn't actually that difficult.
I don't know where I'm at right now.
You're on top.
Leap of faith.
Oh.
I meant I like I knew where I was at, but I didn't actually know.
That's fair.
Oh, Jesus. I hope I didn't need that. Okay, well.
Oh, man.
Oh, buddy.
Oh, no.
Look at the little skeleton face.
Well, now I get to lose all of my upgrades in one go.
Well, you know, if you do it better, though, you won't, right?
Because the thing moves,
right.
The platform moves too fast for you to see the threats coming. There,
oh.
Well, there's that.
You already lost your helmet.
So hopefully I don't need that.
No, no.
Oh, good.
You only needed it to get in here.
There we go. So this thing's happening.
Oh, shit. Oh, there you go. At least you got there. That's good. Oh, except that's not good. That's less good.
I think this is the part that broke Cujo, too.
For everyone at home, I can't do anything in this game.
Spin jump is your friend. I'm going to put that out there.
Oh, it's not the same distance no matter what.
I think it is if you're moving left and right.
Oh, man, look at that. Yoshi wants to get
moving.
Saved.
Oh, no. You're trying... No, yeah. No, that's not how that works. Wait.
I don't think you jump higher.
If I spin jump off of these, will I bounce?
I don't remember, to be totally
You know, there's a
honest.
Way to find out, Nathan.
I think
you... try it.
I don't think you do with Mario.
You're about to find out.
I know.
Oh, hey, look at that.
I know that the helmet works. If you
oh,
hit
look
your
at
head
that, Nathan. There's the goal line
see,
right
man.
Down there.
See?
Yeah, but that's not... I should have checked and see if there was a saver there. But too late now. Oh, yep. A Yoshi.
Yeah.
All right. I have leveled up. That is an evil face. Is this the sad face? It is. All right. Yoshi time.
Good
let's see. I have
level.
Passed... shit. Wait. Let me guess. Okay, yeah.
Just run for it, man. Bam.
Yeah, I can watch you bounce in between that for a while.
Look how easy this part is now. Shit, man.
What part? Oh.
Now you got Yoshi. You can just breeze right through it.
If you can get up to the upper level. Okay.
Although I'm sure if a thwomp comes down on you.
Well.
Then you get hit and you have a chance of recovering Yoshi.
Oh, you do? Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Little Mario riding Yoshi is the weirdest looking thing. He looks
it
like he's wearing like earmuffs or something. It's
yeah, right. It's like Yoshi was sorry to say, but you have a little Italian tumor on you.
Yeah, I do remember saying that I needed Yoshi.
So, Chris, has anyone successfully completed this level yet?
No.
I'm not saying that's a bad thing. Hold on. I'm just asking.
It's only because it's too long. It's not because it's too hard. It's because it's too long. That's it. It's difficulty by itself is totes fine. It's just the length.
Yeah.
Because
no.
When you combine length with difficulty, that makes it... Oh, you son of a bitch. I swear to God. Then you lose...
Hey, there's a lot of thwomps there.
How the fuck?
Gotta have the helmet, man. That's the final room. I guess I could make it so all you need is Yoshi to get through that port.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm like, I understand why you did it that way.
It feels conclusive, right?
Yeah, exactly. But it's like, if I get hit and I lose Yoshi, I have to go back through that area. If I get hit and I lose my helmet, I have to go back and get the helmet.
Yeah, I think
so
I'd rather just make
that one part where you're
it...
like, yeah, the helmet doesn't matter anymore. It does, because now that I have Yoshi, I still have to go back and get the helmet. Nah. But I'm going to lose Yoshi here. No, I'm not. You know what I'm going to say for right there, right? You know what I'm going to say? You know what I'm going to say, right?
That's too hard?
That... You know what I'm going to say there, right? No. No, that one part that... Like, that it's only, like, that much of a gap to jump through. And when you have Yoshi, you can't gauge your shit.
What? can't gauge your shit.
You can't gauge.
I don't know what you're saying anymore, man.
You can't gauge your fucking shit.
I think there's like a gauge for how big your shit can get, and I think that's what
and,
trying
to say. And
you
can't do it. You can't gauge it if this shit, if it's too small for your shit to fit through.
I had a big shit once. Kind of scared me a little bit, just like...
No, man, you gotta take pride in that shit.
Got one more try. I've got one more try in me, okay, and then what's gonna happen is you're just gonna beat it on your own and then pretend that I did it and then overlap the recording as if they happened at the same time.
I'm and just gonna then show I'm you going like, to fucking yeah, as you, as I'm just like winning through it, and it won't make sense because you'll be in anguish.
No,
but
you just make fun of Nathan.
No, I'm just gonna record now a victory dance. Be like, yeah, I totally beat that. That was all me.
I was waiting for the victory dance off the stage.
Bam, I'm done. I don't even care anymore. I don't even care. I'm out.
Yeah, Audi 500.
I'm out.
Like that Audi RTX. Support us, Audi. We really need the money.
Now you get to beat it and pretend like I actually did it. Okay, okay.
Oh, shit. You can beat it in 3 tries. What does it take you, an hour?
Yeah, I got a few wins myself, but still, it's really hard.
It's a much, much different feel than any other Street Fighter, and I think
so. Like, this is where I'd be like, aha, aha, ha, but I don't even care anymore to even do that.
But you still did it, so you clearly had more care.
No.
Oh, no. Oh.
Trust me.
Oh.
Look at that.
Yeah.
I'm all powered up, bitch.
Look at that. The creator of the level is doing well in his level.
Not well. He's already died twice.
I've died once.
You died once.
Once, twice.
The same thing.
A failure's a failure.
We're happy people.
Oh.
Bitch ass.
That's,
see, in my playthroughs, I wouldn't have had to do that because for some reason he was dead already.
Yeah, I don't know why, man. Those thwomps were killing him.
That's how it works. That's just how it works. That's okay. What it does, though.
Alright. Oh, yeah, this part.
It's clever.
If you don't know this trick, it makes this a lot more difficult. But if you use this trick...
Is Swamp just, Swamp's broken, huh?
Yep. That was... I put him...
Oh, that's because his original starting point is too high. All right.
Exactly.
Right there.
I did that exactly so that you had to push the Thwomp up to advance to the next part of the stage.
Which meant that if you were lost...
I mean, you don't actually have to. You can jump off of Yoshi, but...
Well, yeah, but then you don't have Yoshi.
Yeah.
And then you probably can't make it through this. Speaking of which, fuck you.
Ah, nice.
Yeah, nice.
Nice.
Hurrah.
Fucking Bowser.
Why don't you just breathe in the fire?
I don't think you can. What? Holy shit!
Holy shit!
I didn't actually know that that was a thing.
Holy shit!
Can I use
ultimately,
that to kill the chain
really
chomp?
Change up the design of your level. It's just
no,
like
it doesn't control. Change anything.
Yeah.
It actually, well, it makes it slightly easier, but not tremendously.
Trust me, easier. It does not make the level... It does, yeah, it really does not make anything easier.
There are a lot of...
God damn it, Yoshi. Whatever, I don't need this bitch anymore.
That's
as
true.
As you go, I was lying to you, baby. It's okay.
Coins! Did this get published?
Yeah. Not many people have played it yet.
Yeah, unless you're already at the top, it's really hard to get people to...
Yeah, I was hoping social media would help with that, but not really.
I'm looking at this and having a mental panic attack.
Yeah, I would hate this.
No, this sounds, looks awesome. Oh. I would do this over and over again, but that's why I made a whole thing dedicated to boss battling.
Oh. What?
Secret?
Nope.
Oh, it's just the end of the level.
That final platform, all it does, or that final, like, skull platform, all it does is bring you down. It's just so that you know that I didn't actually mean for this to block your exit. I should have opened that skull's mouth so you could actually leave. I hate it when people block the exit and Mario's just like, why? I hate it. It pisses me off every time. And then I did it accidentally and I was just like, God damn it. That's the level. That's the level. That's the level. Two tries.
How long did that take you?
To make or to play?
Yes. just now, like...
About 10 minutes.
No, you did not beat that in 10 minutes. Yeah. You only have 500 seconds to finish a level.
Between the two playthroughs.
You only have 500 seconds to
finish. How many minutes is that?
500.
Come on, guys, let's
look. You'll leave that math alone.
Let's think about it, guys. Let's think about it!
I don't know, man. Like, 5 minutes?
Oh, Chris.
I agree, it's too long.
Yeah, no, that's it. But the problem with it is that...
Here, sit down. We'll make this the end of the episode.
I'm gonna nutshot you.
Hey, man.
Oh, I'm a genius. Okay. So, what's the first upgrade? It's the mushroom, right?
Right.
All
right.
Go back to the mushroom. Okay, cool. So, here's what you do. You have that little thing down below, that block, right? And that's to show the player you need the mushroom in order to pass this. And that's you telling the player this is a skill that you're going to need. That's why it's a Metroidvania. Have that instead of that be a way to continue on. Like, allow it for the player to be able to continue on originally to get the items without the other items. Because in a Metroidvania, generally that's how it would work. Like, in Zelda, Metroid, you would be able to get those items, but to get to the other areas, you would need those items, right?
So what I could do is do something like this.
And basically, you require the helmet in order to get to the door, which leads to the beginning of the level.
Okay, I dig that, actually.
And a little secret here. You're worried about, like, Yoshi being able to get up there or whatever. Put the door there. Now delete that platform below it.
This?
Yep, and then the other one, boom. So what's going to happen is every time they show up the door, they come down because it's a secret
fair.
That haunted house stages do all the time.
Yeah, I just don't like it because it looks ugly. So we'll do like that, right? You can't really enter the door unless you have the helmet.
Yep. You might want to put like some type of indicator right there. I don't know, like coins or something, being like, don't go here until you have your thing. Or wait, where's the little guy at? Where's the little guy at?
Guy?
The helmet guy. The symbol on the sit, like right here. I don't mean on your...
Yeah.
Go to left. Where is he at? Where's the helmet at?
The helmet is here.
Oh, it's right there. Okay, that's showing you need the helmet. Never mind. That's a good place. Because I was going to say you could put the helmet right there and be like, you're not going to be able to go through without the helmet, but you don't, I mean, like you're
already I can do that.
That. You're already doing it once, so I don't know if you want
to
do that.
Well, no, if we do it here, then I don't need to have it over there.
Fair enough.
Because I don't understand that whenever you have those, you can use the helmet.
You can do spikes instead of those.
Actually, yeah, I think that would...
It looks a little, like it doesn't exactly fit the theme of the spikes so far. And then definitely put a door on top of it. Now there is one issue to this.
I'm a silly little pretty bitch.
As Mario, if you're big, you can totally jump in and get to that door.
Yeah,
but why would you want to do that?
You can do the same thing with the thwomp too.
Yeah, that's true. And why would you want to do that? That would be bad for you.
The point is still delivered, I think. These guys climb. I'll do...
Pick something that's gonna move back and forth, because that's what you want, right? One of the...
These guys work.
Yeah, that's right.
And you can't kill them and put their little spiky helmets on, so it shouldn't be game-breaking.
Nothing I can think of. Will it move down? Nope, to the right. See the spine, right there. You said that you wanted that to be the spine, right?
Should
I don't. You should do something to tell the player you can't go here. This will kill you if you try to go and explore there. You know it's not even, right?
It isn't?
No.
One, two, three.
Look at the teeth.
Oh my.
I had a weird life.
You need a way for the player to see that area with the thwomps as they're walking by. but the inability to be able to pass it. So for instance, if this floating platform down here,
mm-hmm.
if you put it up, if you had a way of putting it up higher to where the thwomps would smash down, players would look at, what they would do is they would look at the line there and be like, all right, so something's supposed to travel on the track. Same time, there's thwomps, and I know I can't, there's no way I can pass that right now. So what I need to do is I need to find a way to get a helmet or whatever that's going to allow me to pass. But they need to be able to see that ahead of time. And if they see it ahead of time, they'll be deterred from going in that direction later.
The height of these coins is also to show the player that they should be big.
That's good.
I don't know if you can see the coins from here, though. Not really.
It doesn't really matter. Like, if they do get brave and they're like, I really want to try this right now, then they're going to die. And they're going to be like, well, a smart player would be like, well, that was my fault.
Yeah.
I should have known I couldn't get past that. That's what happened to me. And I didn't feel like, I wasn't like pissy. It was like, oh, yeah, I should have known I couldn't pass that. So, that breakable block right there, why is that breakable? That part right there.
The idea was it was supposed to make it more challenging on the way back, but since we're not having the player go back, it suddenly becomes arbitrary. Yeah, I don't want players to be surprised at where these guys are. Okay, well that kind of works. If you're paying attention, you should be able to see those guys. We could make these slower and...
Oops. If you make them slower, the problem is you risk, because, like, if they die... Oh, well then, yeah, that would make sense.
So we do... Get out of here. I'm invincible, bitch. So suddenly, I can just do this, right?
Yeah,
I feel like
I understand
that makes it...
why you would not want to do that, though.
Right, it makes it kind of easy. Did you catch all of the faces that I put in here? Like, here's my little Cyclops Skelly.
I didn't, because you jumped down the thing too early.
Oh, that's fair. And then I have,
Like, I recognize you'd put one there.
Then I've got this guy.
Ah!
And then the guy you're all familiar with.
Hey! My neck used to be weird.
And then this guy.
I don't have a lower jaw! Half face.
That was kind of my theming with this, right? I had lots of little, like, skeleton stuff going on.
Skelly heads.
Back to the original topic, theme was the whole point of this episode.
Well, it's based off of a Metroidvania you called Mariovania. And, Metroidvanias are difficult.
Mm-hmm.
They are, in some regards, a little tedious, definitely adventurous and explorative. And they, in this regard, you homed in on the idea that you need multiple special abilities, so to say, equipments. It's a equipment fetch quest, right? So you that's like the thing that you kind of like... That was the huge theme of the thing was like, first you're gonna need a mushroom, then you're gonna need a helmet, then you're gonna need a Yoshi. These other parts cannot be passed without these items. The only issue with that theme is that it caused the level just to be too long.
Yeah, and that's kind of where theme kind of starts being less important than actual level design.
Yeah.
And obviously this, I focus purely on theme rather than level design. I mean, obviously there was level design involved, right? But I let theme take precedence.
Yeah.
And that's what made it too difficult.
Yeah, it's having that fine balance. But as far as how to build a themed level went, I would say you definitely hit it on the nose.
And the other thing, too, that I liked about the theming is that I included an aesthetic theme along with the gameplay theme, right? Mm-hmm. I went very much with the cavey feel and with, like, skeletons, right? So yeah. I put little skeleton faces all over the place. I used a lot of dry bones. And, I mean, the thwomps were certainly a reoccurring element, but I don't think thematically they worked as well. But, like...
It's, I mean, you only have so many assets to work with that are going to function.
Exactly. But I tried to have the aesthetic theme be incorporated through the actual, like, level components, right? Like, I built the skull just out of the wall pieces.
Yeah, no, I actually, that's, it's funny because I did, I actually think I put, like, words and stuff in my boss battle, which was also underground. Mm-hmm. The underground stages are just really fun for putting stuff into the walls. Yeah, so theme-wise, I would definitely say you hit it on the head.
Yes. I guess then to finish off the episode, we should at least play through the level at least once.
Yeah. Give me
that, Cujo. At least since we changed it, right? We should see, make sure that our door system makes sense.
Thank you.
All right, well.
What's
up, badass? Whoa, whoa, whoa. We gotta say goodbye to everyone, Nathan.
Oh, my God.
Say goodbye, Nathan.
Goodbye. Thank you for watching, everybody. All right.
Yeah, see you in the archives or something.
If you like this episode, then definitely give us a subscribe or a like, and we would love to hear what people want to see in the future. So give us some ideas of what kind of level design topics you want us to talk about. And Geekarius won't be here next time.
Hey, fuck you guys.
Thanks for watching, everybody.
Don't hate on me.
I am.
Love me, man.
Okay, here we go.
Baby, there you go. Ooh, yeah. Mm. Ooh, a little chub is never a bad thing.
Wait a second.
Oh, yeah. Shit gets real here.